This is D Brown, the Begotten Son, and today we're gonna dive within the sound wave of Light Up.
Oh yeah. Oh, I'm in it now. I already know B-Son. Begotten sounds, man. Light up, light up, Lego, Lego, light up. Let go. Imagine all their faces if you pull out something mean.
Easy, straightforward, light up, let's go, you know, and then imagine their faces when you, if you pull out something mean. One of those things where they think of you a certain way, they only see you as a certain person, but right when you pull out something mean, as in a car or anything that you, that they would say flex, anything that's a flex point, basically, that's when they start looking at you differently. That's how I start up this whole song. That's actually how I start off with this, and I'm just setting the stage for that hook right there.
You can tell it right, I keep them niggas on their job, never on their heels, I'm on their head. Job, music is my religion, I'm never at us, think a string is on it, don't know where they hits. Nah.
Basically, with these lyrics right here, I feel like it's straightforward, keep it on their head job and all that. I say that in a way, punchline with that is basically like, you know, you staying on their head. In culture, what stays on somebody's head? A hijab. That's where that line comes in at. And seeing that I basically reference the whole thing about with Muslims, that is a religion also. So then I say music is my religion. That's the string right there where I tie that in. Music is my religion, never at odds. And then move right on to the next part. You would think they had a string on them, basically like a puppet making their heads nods, and then it goes right into the next line. That ties into the next line for the whole puppet idea.
I ain't a puppet master, I'm the king of Asgard. I'm the one with lightning, you can go and ask your god. Out of space with it, I'm supposed to be amongst the stars, mining asteroids for never before seen bars.
Just tying it right in, like I said, puppet master. And then we move right over to the king of Asgard and all that, which basically, if you remember anything about Thor, you know, his kingdom, his father's kingdom, the kingdom that he was supposed to take over, Asgard and all that. So there you go right there. Seeing that is found out of space, I'm out of space with it. You can go ahead and ask your god. I say your god because a lot of people have different names for God and all that. So whatever your religion is, this is basically pertaining to that. Once again, tying in the religion that I brought forth in the earlier bars. Seeing that I'm out of space with it, I'm mining asteroids for never before seen bars. I take this in because, of course, on asteroids, there's a whole thing of the different elements that asteroids have. A lot of elements that is probably hard to find here on Earth, and also a lot of elements as in like diamonds and all that, where it might be something that's seen as precious here, but when it comes to asteroids and everything out in space, there's actually an abundance of diamonds. So when I go to an asteroid, when I speak this line right here, I'm saying mining asteroids for never before seen bars pertaining to the elements that you can find. And also coming back to rap, you know, I'm looking for a different way to bring different types of lyrics that haven't been seen or heard before.
Yeah, yeah, I'm of a different element. Oh yeah, the competition ain't relevant. I ain't leaving no one on the fence. Come down, let's get down. I come in here with one mission, like Bender, leaving niggas hella bent.
So seeing that I just said what I said about the whole asteroid thing, that's why I say, yeah, I'm of a different element, you know. And then I move on with a lot of different lyrics right here that's basically straightforward. And then I just end off the bars right here, just basically saying like Bender leaving niggas hella bent, which is Bender from Futurama. A lot of stuff that's just staying with the whole space theme right there.
Oh, you mad? Man, I leave them spicy. Man, they should've known. All I eat is spicy. Yeah, I love them spices. Love to bite like Tyson. I'm a beast just like them. Now watch me go and light them.
Little tidbits about me where I love spices. I love spicy food. That's all I eat. All of it straightforward. And then I also come back with the viciousness of one, of course, spicy food. If you're not used to it, it can be hard and harsh on your body. So bringing it hard and harsh, I come through with the viciousness of a Mike Tyson. Of course, we all know by now his whole biting scandal. Just seeing him as just a monster, as a beast at it, and especially in that moment where he just shows that he just did not care. So that's where I was just leaving this whole verse.
Yeah.
And then this part right here with this voice, Mr. Screw voice, This is actually me with the screwed voice that I actually said, just to break down the lyrics real quick. Get the rockers, get them lit up. Ain't no stopping none of my hitters. Once again, staying with the whole space theme. Rockets get you out in space, we're taking them higher, light up. There you go. And then I brought this one right here because I wanted a certain element within this song, and I decided to, instead of sampling, because I really don't like to sample like that, I like to make from scratch. So I decided to go ahead and say this, screw it up, and then add on some other type of effects, some phasers, tremolos, to make it sound more like a sample. Something that felt good to get that little bounce to it. I was looking for a certain bounce, and I felt like the way I said these lyrics right here, and the way it sounds like a nice sample that gets you on that little bounce with it.
Shoulda known begotten son is ill. They mistaken and think I'm from Queens the way I'm ill. Way I spit that bubonic, I'm leaving niggas ill. Sounding like Sarah without the H, cause H is ill.
Starting off the second verse, I have a lot of fun with the word ill. You know, I say, of course, I'm ill, just like a hip hop term that we've been using in hip hop for the longest time. When I say I'm ill when I spit, and because of that, we all heard the different ways of just using this word ill. So I bring it for the second lines, basically to give homage to Nas. So when I say they think I'm from Queens the way I'm ill, from Illmatic, the way I spit that bubonic, I'm leaving niggas ill. So what I spit is sick, and I'm getting people sick off of it, type thing. And then the last one is funny one, is actually an esoteric one. If you actually watch Jimmy Fallon, then you will actually get this line. But if you don't, then you will actually have to check out Jimmy Fallon and some of his skits when he do things about Sarah. My name is Sarah without the H, because H is ill. And the way he does it is just like a funny way of doing it. So if you know anything about Jimmy Fallon and Sarah, then boom, you got that.
I'm one of those artists that ain't looking for a deal. 100% all me, fortified still. And I say it like my chest free, the man is still. Walking unscathed right across your mind field.
I'm not looking for a deal. I do this because I want my stuff. I want to own my stuff. I want to have creative control. That's basically how I feel about when I bring these things. And then of course they all, when you always got the saying of say it with your chest and everything. So instead of just saying say it with my chest, you know, I say it like my chest read the Man of Steel. You know, of course the Superman thing. And then everything else in that part right there is basically straightforward.
Let it blow, watch me light up. They wanna keep you dim, they hate it when you bright up. It's in my nature, I'm only doing what light does. See that halo effect on me like I'm righteous.
So let it blow, of course, watch me light up. When something blow, of course it lights up. They wanna only keep you dim. You know, they always wanna keep you at a certain level because that's where they're comfortable at. That's where they comfortable knowing you at. But they hate it when they see you light up. It's one of those things where it's basically you're either gonna let your light shine, as we always hear, or you're just gonna keep it dim just to appease the masses around you and all that. So that's why I just move right over to the part where I'm just like, you know, I'm only doing what light does. I'm only doing what light knows how to do, which is shine. So that's what I'm just gonna do. I'm gonna do me, which is shine. And through that shining, you're gonna see the halo effect on me like I'm righteous. You know, of course the halo that you see in pictures of different saints and angels and all that stuff.
I see the plank in their eyes, so how these niggas judge? I show exactly who I am, I'm not a mad singer. And you sounding crazier than a cold shirt zinger. No clue about my character and my poised demeanor.
Seeing that I just pointed out about the halo effect, keep following the thread. I just come right over to the whole thing about seeing a plank in the eye. Right there, that's a whole a religious statement right there. That's basically saying, you know, watch how you judge somebody, because are you even looking at yourself and the flaws that you have about yourself? So seeing that it's talking about judging people, that's why I say, how did these niggas judge, you know? Then I follow that thread, just keeping that thread going. Judging, I moved that over to the show that's just killing it right now, Masked Singer. And then from Masked Singer, I say, you know, you're sounding crazier than Nicole Scherzinger, which is funny to me because if you ever watch that show, then you know when it comes to her, you know, when she'd give out a guess and say, I think it's such and such, and for the longest, I think it's Jamie Foxx, you know, and it'd be like, you'd be hearing, especially for a lot of these people in that mask, you'd be hearing them and you'd be like, that is obviously not this person. Just as a little tongue-in-cheek, it's like, oh, you sounding crazier than Nicole, you know? You have no clue about my character and my poised demeanor. So tie all that in, from Mad Singer and Nicole Scherzinger to guessing all wrong, so you have no clue about my character and my poised demeanor. Of course, for that, it's just me being laid back and all that. So you can't really guess, you can't really read my face when I'm just laid back, just chilling and not, and just basically having on a poker face. This right here is just a good deep dive into the lyrics, and a lot of fun stuff that's going on with these lyrics too. So when you get a chance, listen back at that. And my name is D Brown, the Begotten Son, and I'm out.
Yeah. Ain't no stopping them, my haters get them rockets, get them lit up. Ain't no stopping them, my haters
know what I'm on.
Get them lit up, ain't no stopping them, my